गुड डे एवरीवन, माई सेल्फ ऋषभ मालविया, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फार्मेसी, स्कूल ऑफ मेडिकल एंड अलाइड साइंसेस, गलगोटियाज यूनिवर्सिटी। टूडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट फार्मास्यूटिकल इमल्सन। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, डिफिनीशन ऑफ इमल्सन। इमल्सन इज ए बाइफेजिक लिक्विड डोजेस फॉर्म इन विच टू लिक्विड्स आर यूज and one liquid is present as globules in the another liquid present as continuous phase. An emulsion is a thermodynamically unstable system consisting mixture of two or more immiscible liquids which is stabilized by adding emulsifying agent. Emulsion are part of a more general class of two phase system or matter called collad. Emulsion should be used when both the dispersed and the continuous phase are liquid. It means emulsion are generally prepared when both dispersed phase and continuous phase are liquid medium. Example of emulsions include vinegar, milk and mayonnaise. It means emulsion is a biphasic liquid dosage form and it is thermodynamically unstable. It consists two immiscible liquid. Among these liquid, one liquid is present as globules while another is present as continuous phase. There are five types of emulsion used in pharmaceutical. One is oil in water emulsion, also known as O by W emulsion. Second is water in oil emulsion, and it is known as W by O emulsion. Third is multiple emulsion, O by W by O or W by O by W. In this case, initially one phase is prepared, W by O emulsion is prepared, and it is used as continuous phase. Another liquid, that is oil, is added and mixed, and it form O by W by O emulsion. In the same way, W by O by W emulsions are also prepared. Fourth type is micro emulsion, in which globular size of liquid is dispersed phase liquid is in micron. And fifth is nano emulsion, in which dispersed phase globular size is in nanometer. It means micro and nano emulsion are classified on the basis of globular size. While oil in water emulsion, water in oil emulsion and multiple emulsions are classified on the basis of continuous phase and dispersed phase. There are some identification tests which are used to identify whether oil is present in dispersed phase or water is present in dispersed phase. First test is dilution test. In dilution test, when a emulsion is diluted with continuous phase, it becomes stable. While when an emulsion is diluted with dispersed phase, it becomes unstable. Based on the solubility of external phase of emulsion, dilution test is used. O by W emulsion can be diluted with water and remain stable, while W by O emulsion can be diluted with oil and it remain stable. But in the case of O by W emulsion, means in O by W emulsion, oil is present in dispersed phase and water is present in continuous phase. When this emulsion is diluted with dispersed phase, it remain unstable. And when O by W emulsion is diluted with continuous phase, that is water, it remains stable. Second test is conductivity test. Water is a good conductor of electricity, whereas oil is a non-conductor. When anode and cathode are kept in a emulsion and wires are connected with a bulb, when water is present in continuous phase, a circuit will complete and bulb will glow. But when oil is present in continuous phase, circuit will not be complete because oil is a bad conductor of electricity and bulb will not glow. In this way, conductivity test is used to identify whether oil is present in dispersed phase or water is present in dispersed phase. Dye solubility test is another test used to identify the dispersed phase and continuous phase. When an emulsion is mixed with water soluble dye such as amaranth and observed under the microscope, if the continuous phase appears red, then it means that emulsion is O by W type, as water is in external phase, water is present in continuous phase. If the scattered globules appear red, it means water is present in dispersed phase and it is OW by O type emulsion. The basic concept is that water soluble dye only go with water side and it shows red color under microscope. Last test is fluorescence test. Some fixed oil give fluorescence under UV light while water does not. Therefore, O by W emulsion shows spot and W by O emulsion fluorescence. Stability of an emulsion is basic concern because thermodynamically emulsions are unstable system. An emulsion is said to be stable if it remains as such after its preparation. That is, the dispersed phase globules are uniformly distributed throughout the dispersion medium, that is continuous phase, during its storage. The emulsion should be chemically stable and there should not be any bacterial growth during its shelf life. Emulsion instability may either reversible or irreversible and manifest in following ways. First is cracking. Cracking is irreversible instability. Flocculation means floccule formation. It is reversible. Creaming, again it is reversible. And phase inversion is also a reversible process. But in some cases, phase inversion also becomes irreversible, depending upon the ratio of continuous phase and dispersed phase. Now we will study about cracking. Cracking means separation of two layers of dispersed and continuous phase. In cracking, dispersed phase and continuous phase are separated out and two layers are appeared. While in ideal emulsion, there should not be layering. Cracking may occur due to the following reason: by addition of emulsifying agent of opposite type, by decomposition or precipitation of emulsifying agent, by addition of common solvent, maybe due to presence of microorganism, maybe due to change in temperature, and by creaming. These are the basic reason which may cause cracking. Now we will study about flocculation. In flocculated state, the secondary interaction means van der Waals forces maintain the droplet at a defined distance of separation. In flocculation, the dispersed phase globules linked with each other come close to each other and form a big globules that is known as floccules. Application of shearing stress to the formulation, that may be shaking, will redisperse these droplets to form a homogeneous formulation. It means flocculation is a non-irreversible process. It is a reversible process. Now we will study about creaming. Creaming may be defined as the upward movement of dispersed phase globules to form a thick layer at the surface of emulsion. Creaming is a temporary phase and it can be redistributed by mild shaking. But cracking is irreversible process and creaming is reversible process. In this slide, we will study about phase inversion. Phase inversion means conversion of dispersed phase into continuous phase or conversion of continuous phase into dispersed phase. Phase inversion may take place due to by the addition of an electrolyte, by changing the phase volume ratio, by change in temperature, or by changing the emulsifying agent. The phase inversion can be minimized by keeping concentration of dispersed phase between 30 to 60%, and by storing the emulsion in cool place and using a proper emulsifying agent in adequate concentration. We should remind that phase inversion means conversion of dispersed phase into continuous phase and conversion of continuous phase into dispersed phase. It means conversion of O by W type emulsion into W by O type emulsion. From the complete study, it can be summarized that emulsion is a biphasic liquid dosage form. Emulsion can be administered to children and elderly patients, and stability is a major concern for the emulsion dosage form. Following question arises after the complete study. Question may be, define pharmaceutical emulsion, enlist various identification tests for an emulsion, differentiate between creaming and cracking, and define emulsifying agent. These are some references that can be referred for further study. Thank you very much. You can contact on the given email ID and contact number for any query.